Hello everyone. Welcome to my online classes. Today we'll discuss a very important topic, structure of bacterial cell. It's important not only for your syllabus, it's also important for your competitive exam. I'll explain about structure of bacteria. Understand well. Try to understand. When we observe the bacterial cell, it is a quite unique cell. Don't you think that is because it is surviving in all kinds of extreme conditions, should we have some protective structures? And we have, in case of bacteria, there are protective structures. That's why bacteria can survive. These structures are enabling bacteria to survive in such kind of harsh conditions. We'll take one by one. So try to understand with the help of this diagram. See, we will start from outside and then we will enter to inside. So when we take about bacterial structure, so first what we are observing, there is a covering before cell wall. Before cell wall, there is one additional covering, and that is the very important covering in case of the bacteria. That covering is known as capsule, we call capsule, and we can also call slime layer. So this is the additional covering, and it gives bacteria that one protection. It is for the extra protection to bacteria. This capsule is determining the nature of the bacteria. In certain bacteria, there are having the capacity to cause disease instantly. They are highly infectious in nature. When they get their host, they can enter inside the host and they can infect. It is due to this slime layer, this capsule, because they can adhere, they can attach rapidly. That is the advantage. And this additional layer, this capsulated layer, slime layer, enabling bacteria to virulent. So what is virulent? Virulent is the biological term which means disease causing capacity. It means those bacteria who are virulent, they can cause disease. So this slime layer is making many bacteria virulent. And we have one of the commonest example, that is Diplococcus. It is causing pneumonia, and we observed many times. It is a very infectious disease, pneumonia. And then we have, next to capsule or slime layer, we have a cell wall. And cell wall of bacteria is different from other plants. It is completely different, having the different chemical composition. And this is the also reason of the success of the bacteria in the extreme conditions. See that one. That is murine and peptidoglycan. These are the two chemicals who are enabling bacteria to survive in extreme conditions. Bacteria can survive in high temperature, extremely cold conditions, and that in salt region, halophiles we discussed. So these are the some harsh conditions where life is not possible. They are growing in that region. They are surviving in that region. It is due to their protection, and it is due to the uniqueness of the cell wall. That cell wall is very unique. That's why they are able to survive. Next to cell wall, we have plasma membrane. So we know that what is the role of the plasma membrane. It is surrounding protoplasm. It means inside we have a cytoplasm as well as genetic material, and it is surrounded by a plasma membrane. It also guides and that one we can say that checks the entry of the unwanted substances in it, and it is also having a semi permeable nature. It means substances who are necessary to enter, it can enter, and substances who can make harm inside the cell, it can't be enter inside the cell. So that is the nature of the plasma membrane, we know that. So when we move inside, it means next to plasma membrane, there is this region, and this region is known as cytoplasm. Every cell has a cytoplasm. Bacteria are also having cytoplasm. When we observe the cytoplasm, what we are getting, inside the cytoplasm there is a presence of the food granules, ribosomes. These are the two structures. We know that ribosomes are responsible for the protein synthesis. They have the that one function, that is the whole sole function is protein synthesis. Wherever they are present, in eukaryotic cells also they do protein synthesis, in prokaryotic cells they are also doing protein synthesis. So here is also we have the protein synthesis, and it is due to the various kinds of structures. There is ribosomes are there for the protein synthesis. Food granules is for the supplying of the energy, so they get food as well. So these are scattering inside the ribosomes. When we observe that one, this plasma membrane, it is enfolded at some places, and they are forming a structure, this membrane. It is forming a structure by the enfolding, that is known as mesosomes. It is considered as mitochondria, because we are discussing about prokaryotic cells, and prokaryotic cells are not having mitochondria. We know that. All the prokaryotic cells are lacking membrane bound structure. That's the reason we are not observing endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi apparatus. There are other double membranous structures are completely absent. In bacteria they are completely absent, but we have a enfolding of the plasma membrane, and this enfolding is making a structure. That structure is known as mesosomes. A very important role in case of the bacteria, that is for the generation of the energy. We know that we are taking food, but we have the production of energy when that food is burnt inside the body. That is the concept, respiration. So whenever we have respiration, we have the burning of the food substances what we have taken, and it is done by mitochondria. But in case of the prokaryotic cells, due to absence of mitochondria, the burning of the food and release of the energy is done by mesosomes. Okay, simple. And then after mesosomes, we can see there is a genetic material in this one. This is genetic material, because it is prokaryotic cell, it is not surrounded by any kind of membrane. It means nuclear membrane is completely absent. You can see it is a genetic material. And then there is also, in case of the bacteria, genetic material is circular, not linear. As we see in eukaryotic cell, it is completely different kinds of shape in case of prokaryotic cell. And we have a single chromosome. That is the also the concept. And many times student commit mistake to solve questions based on this genetic material. So try to focus and understand. That is circular genetic material in case of the bacteria, circular. and this is single chromosome is there, single chromosomes in the bacterial cell. Okay, there is one structure which is coming out, it is kind of extension, and this structure is flagella, and we know the function of flagella because we already discussed this one in the previous topic. We have the locomotion of the bacteria due to this structure, that is flagella. So this structure is responsible for the locomotion of bacteria. It means displacement of the bacteria from one place to another place is done by flagella. So it's a locomotory organ. Okay everyone, have you understood? I gave you the structure of the bacteria, explanation of the structure of the bacteria. There is a one very special structure in case of the bacterial cell. See that one, it is known as pili or fimbri. So as we know that bacteria need to attach whenever it is having a exchange of the genetic material, because there is no true sexual reproduction is not happening. We have the exchange of the genetic material is happening to get recombination, and that's why they need to attach to other bacteria whenever they get chance. So we have a pili or fimbri, it is serving as a attachment for attachment to the surface and for the attachment to another bacteria to do exchange of the genetic material to fulfill the process of recombination so that they can get the variation. And to get variation, they can have the survival. Okay, everyone. So these are the very important points we discussed. You need to go through all these points, understand. And when you have any problem to understand, you can ask me your questions. I will wait of your questions. Till then, keep on learning and improving your skills. We'll meet again. Till then, goodbye.